From New Heights Training Stables and Graceland Equestrian Center. And today, I'm gonna teach you how to see a distance. We're going to start by practicing cantering over a single pole on the ground and counting down to our distance. 3, 2, 1. An important part of jumping is the canter and the elasticity of the canter, being able to adjust the canter to a shorter or longer stride so that when you come to a fence, you're able to shorten or lengthen your stride and get the optimal distance. Coming into one of these lines, we need to get a shorter step and see a shorter distance coming into our very first fence. Next, we'll canter through and ride in a long 3 strides. When riding a longer distance in the middle of the line, we need to keep coming and have a more opening lengthened canter stride at the first fence and throughout the line. 1, 2, 3, land. 1, 2, 3. I generally see my distance 3 to 5 strides out. On a good day, I'll see 6 or 7. The farther out you can see your distance, the better it's going to work out. So the first time I come through this line, I'm going to wait and not adjust her stride until the end of the line. When I add the step there, it'll be too late. It'll be an ugly distance. This time, I'm going to shorten the stride early on in the line so that we keep an even step throughout the rest of the line. Another important element of finding a good distance to the fence is keeping a steady canter rhythm so that there is no big adjustment and you can jump easily out of stride any fence that comes your way. The biggest mistake beginners make in seeing their distance when jumping is forgetting to look for their distance when jumping. If you don't try, you're never going to see it. She loves it. Love the camera, Haley. Love the camera.